Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss another lead code problem, and the problem title is combination sum. So what is given in the description? So here we are given an array and we are given an integer value as a target. So what we have to do is we have to pick up the elements from the array in a such a way that it can be like similar element you can pick up like zero or more number of times, or like you can pick up the distinct elements from the array, but we have to make sure that whatever elements we are going to pick, so those sum should be equal to the target value. And this way we have to find out all the possible list of numbers whose sum is equal to the target value. So let's look at the example one over here. So here the candidate array contains the value 2, 3, 6, 7 and the target is 7. So here we can see like if we can see straightforward, the 7 is one of the possible list of element where we can like 7, if we pick up the 7 from the candidates array, so it's equal to the target value. So one possible set or one possible list is 7. Now again, if we consider the element 2 and 3, so if we pick up the 2 copies of 2 and 1 copy of 3, so like 2 plus 2 plus 3, it becomes 4 plus 3 7. So again it is equivalent to the target value. So that's the whole idea over here. So how we are going to solve this problem? So basically what we have to do is we are going to solve this with the help of recursion, or we can say like a DFS approach we are going to use over here. So before that, what we will do is we will sort the array so that like whatever number set are there whose value is greater than the target value, so it will help us to discard those elements and it will help us to avoid the further traversal through the array. So let's get into the code part. So this is the function combination sum, and here these are the two input parameters. One is the candidates array and another is this target value. And what we have to do return is we have to return the list which has the list of elements and whose combination or whose sum is equivalent to the target. So that's our objective. So first what I'm doing is I'm calculating the length of the array and I'm storing it in the variable n. Then I'm sorting this candidates array. So after that, what I'm doing is I'm just defining the data type, or we can say like return type over here. So this list of list integer, and it is return the linked list. So it will contain the sub list, and eventually we have to return the parent list which will be having the sub list. So after that, I am calling this DFS function over here. So basically DFS contains this candidates array, then length of the array, then whatever target value it is, and we are going to start it from the zeroth index. And here I am creating this array list. It is going to maintain the current list which is having the elements which has either lesser value than the target, or it could be the equal than the target. And finally, this is the parent list object which is defined as a L over here. So here basically in this DFS function, first base condition I am checking over here is whether the left element, that is my target, becomes zero. If it is the case, then at that time I just have to add that current list into my parent list. So that's the simple base condition I have written over here. Apart from that, what I am doing is I am simply iterating through this for loop. So initially this I is zero, so this loop will iterate from zero to the candidates array length, that is the n. So in this case, if we consider the example 1, so the length is 4, so it will iterate from 0 to 3. So every time what I am doing is whatever my target value is there, so I am going to pick up that current index from that candidates array, and I am reducing the target value and I'm storing it into this variable temporary t. So basically I'm checking, after that I'm checking whether that t, like that left or that residue, is greater than or equal to 0. If it is the case, then if it is greater than 0, then again I have a scope to reduce it to the until it becomes 0, or it could be lesser than 0. So what I am doing over here is I am again creating the sublist over here, and I am storing all the elements from whatever my current is there, and after that I am adding the current element in that sublist, and again I am performing the DFS operation based on that sublist value. So basically here the thing is, we can use the multiple copies of the same array element, so that's why I am creating this copy of the array list. So one more thing I need to write over here is, so if the total value is greater than it is lesser than 0, so at that time I just have to break that for loop, so it will avoid the further iteration. So that's the whole idea over here. Now let me quickly run this and let's see the output over here. Okay, so it has passed the criteria, and let's see the test coverage part. So here we can see it has covered all the 168 test cases. So the solution is quite expensive in terms of the space and the time complexity, but in terms of space complexity, it is required to have the list and which contains the sublist. So that's okay for in terms of the space complexity, but in terms of time complexity, I feel it is like big of n factorial as a overall time complexity of this algorithm. But again, if you have any suggestions or corrections, so you can post me in the comment section and I will update the same. So that's it for now, and if you want the full solution of this video or this problem, so you can check out the description section. I have uploaded the GitHub link in the description section below. So that's it for now, and stay tuned for the next one. And if you like this video, so you can do like this video and subscribe to my channel, and please hit the bell icon to get the more updates. Thank you.